Epis Crew.
Hai.
Eh, gue rombong kita. Hai.
Hai guys, come back with me. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to the YouTube channel. Okay, this time I want to talk about the story of Admiralty Law and Maritime Law. Maritime Law, also referred to as Admiralty Law, is nearly as old as the shipping industry itself and covers most accidents that occur on navigable waters. The law roads can be traced back to the underwriting because of nautical behavior of the Egyptians and Greeks. However, the earliest formal codes that were established around on the Greeks and East Leon brought the original maritime laws and custom from the ancient custom and rules of shipping. For example, the doctrine of Grela Veras, the concept that all sea cargo stakeholders on the shipper evenly share any damage or loss that might occur as a result of a voluntary sacrifice of part of the vessel or cargo to save the world can be traced back to the early shipping custom of the Rhodians. The concept of a separate legal authority regulating maritime is so widespread to the first by Eleanor of Aquitaine, who learned of the concept when she accompanied her first husband King Louis VII of France to the Mediterranean on the second crusade. The tempat around the law.
Ini benar berarti.
From the British Admiralty Court to presale the over maritime matters partly from England, common law courts as the US judicial system is based on the British system, and admiralty law were gradually incorporated in the our legal system soon after the Constitution was ratified. Next. Ya
Allah, kok rai lagi ngomong? Rasi. Ram kosok iya.
Emang begila tuh sup.
Wih sedih.
Wah. There are still about some British standard in custom maritime law which lagi lived in the US Constitution or at least international competition, federal statutory law, maritime law and other judicial decision, administrative regulation and custom. Next, when does maritime law apply? Perhaps most obviously, maritime law applies to events that occur on high seas, in other words, accidents that happen beyond the territorial waters of any country. Furthermore, maritime law applies to the territoriality, which are waters within 12 miles of the shore. However, the law applicability becomes less clear further inland. Early in the United States history, maritime law did not apply to accidents that occur within the body of the country, and therefore it included accidents involving the Great Lakes and the Nautidal in later words. However, throughout the 19th century, this equation was error away. Maritime law is now applied to navigable waters, waterways that are navigable by itself or by uniting with other waters. It can serve as a continuing way over which commerce is or might be carried on with other states or foreign countries. Consequently, if a body of water is completely landlocked within a single state, then it is not navigable for purpose of admiralty jurisdiction. However, a body of water doesn't need to flow between states to be deemed navigable. A body of water may be deemed navigable if it is linked in a chain of bodies of water that can be used to service in commerce ultimately. That is that the commerce of one state must be capable of being carried into another state or a foreign country. Once this state has been passed, it is likely that maritime law will be applicable even if it is our constant professor. Next. Kok aku dugu kok mah penak kok tuh oke tak kok.
Ngene lho. Ngene lho. Ya.
Next, incident that recorded as maritime accident at Tournai. Also, maritime injury at Tournai as to help injuries, human or the worst get the compensation, they need to recover from serious injury and offer long some medical costs. The occur outside that include any accident that occur on navigable waters, river and ocean, and in harbor or docks.
Berarti kan so, kalau ini bebas ada penyambung. Karaoke, nak.
Ayo, karaoke.
Wah,
kalau nggak ada masalah sama barang Andre seperti biasa.
Ya, nyedek mie. Ini sudah bincangan dengan Andre ya.
Ah, Mbak Galo mau ngomong gue. Gonceng anu rantri.
Ulah ulah.
Oh, gak maksudnya kan ibu enak adik ibu.
Bejak no.
Ini adik bayu gak dijak sawanan jir sama hari soalnya kan gong gong pitung ulan yo. Si rake selapan air rong enak yo. Uwes. Oh.
Dapat mbak eh. Keserana eh.
Nice.
Anjing dong.
Our maritime lawyer has represented clients who were injured. Ben nak cacing dengan lu gampang sawanan lu. Sawanan ni nuangis terus kayak pemungan lu ketempelan lu kalo. Jack upright accident. Took board and bars accident. Deck accident. Commercial fishing accident. Falls overboard, cargo ship accident, dangerous accident, or parafoam accident, severe accident, crazy ship accident.
Kacang mula aku.
Oh, anak apa anak?
Apa anak? Hmm? Hah? Itu
ya itu. Gak gue,
mas
one
and
a parafoam for each accident. Is that dangerous? Is it that day? Is that there out on devastating of sore electric explosion caused significant damage, special collision, are frequently claustrophobic and oil puff. Ini saya mau aku lanjut. Can unfairly charge the life of workers yang jumbo ini.
Ini apa?
Nah, anu tang jerabu-jerabu tuh.
Kadal ni.
Oh, aku tunggu. By the lawyers try to help her car to cover the conversation they deserve better. They are suffering after major explosion or heavy injury caused by illness of working condition. Okay, okay.
Okay, okay.
Mata aku ira kayak orang turu.
Kalau ada ngantuk, gak sempat ngopi.
Ambil saja petakku.
Titin endas
menyonyong. Okay guys, this is for the discussion about the Stone Maritime Lawyer. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to this channel. And see you next time. Ambil saja petakku. Petakku. Petakku.